Good morning and welcome to United World Capital Daily Market Reviews. Today we can see absolutely different development in the market comparison to yesterday. All the Asian stock markets were adding in price and moving in a positive direction today, except for China. In China, the index is losing 0.2% this morning, and mainly due to the fact that the PetroChina is pulling the index to go down. The PetroChina has presented its quarterly results, which were much lower than the analytics were expected, and the company has declared that its profit for the third quarter has decreased for 33%. On the other side, it's necessary to note that the banking sector in China has presented a very good result, and four biggest banks of China have made profit in third quarter and reported 15% increase. Some more attention shall be given to Japan, where the index adds 1.5% in last 3 days. And mainly here the big influence has been given by the Central Bank of Japan, which has expanded its monetary easing program and added another 11 trillion to it. If to say some words about the United States, when the good news are coming from there, because the Hurricane Sandy is over and the future contracts on the S&P 500 index are adding 0.2% this morning. Due to the fact that the markets in America are closed, it does not have a very big influence on the oil prices, so we can see oil prices bargaining on the same levels as we could see yesterday. So the Brent is a bit losing in price and is traded today in the morning on a level of $109.11 per barrel, and the WTI is traded on $85.66 per barrel. It's obvious what's the most awaited data on the market for this week is the unemployment figures, which are going to come from the United States on Friday, 2nd of November. This is the last figures before the elections in the America, and who knows, maybe it's going to be the last Trump ace. Today in Europe it's going to be quite hot due to the fact that at 12 o'clock there are going to be a meeting of the financial representative of the Eurozone, and at 2 o'clock in the afternoon Troika is going to meet with Greece, which is going to judge how the Greece is following up its austerity measures. Obviously, the situation in the markets becomes to be quite interesting and dramatic because the elections are in America are not so far away. The Spanish and Greek questions are again on the spot, and the companies are continued to present its quarterly results. That's why I wish you to follow the markets, to follow the news, and to make correct decisions. Thank you.